Hi, I'm Jay McClellan, and today I'm going to be doing some diamond engraving with my CNC router. This is what I'm making. It's a diamond engraved anodized aluminum map ruler, and I made it from an anodized aluminum business card blank. I designed this pattern using VCarve Pro software, and I'll show you how I did that. And then I mounted it on my router with a vacuum chuck that I made, and I'll show you how I made that. And then we'll actually do the engraving on one of these, and I'll show you how the tool paths run and scratch the design in with this diamond engraving bit. It goes into the spindle much like any other router bit, but the spindle isn't turning. It's simply pressing the spring-loaded bit down into the surface of the aluminum and scratching this pattern in. The result looks pretty good, I think, at least from a distance. If you look really, really close, the scratches are somewhat ragged, but from a normal viewing distance, the pattern looks sharp and it reflects light differently depending on the angle you hold it at. The card blanks are 0.8 millimeters thick. They come in different colors too. I've made these in black, blue, and green. So this engraving technique should work on most any anodized aluminum surface, or even a non-anodized aluminum or other metal surface. Anything you can scratch a pattern into with the diamond bit. Before we jump into the project, I want to address a question that keeps coming up in the comments. This is my own hair. It's not a wig. It's not a transplant. I don't dye it. I don't put anything on it but shampoo. I just wash it, dry it, brush it out, and that's it. Why is my beard turning gray and my eyebrows turning gray and my hair isn't? No idea. That's just how it grows. Okay, now that looks pretty hideous, I imagine. So I'm going to brush that out and then we'll get started. Here's the card design I did in VCarve Pro. And it's fairly straightforward. The tick marks are all just vectors. And then the text is just using the VCarve text facility. If I zoom in on the text, you can see that each character stroke is three lines, and that's because I used this three line. It's a little bit misleading. It has true type fonts or single line fonts. So this is a single line font, but the 3L actually means it's really a three line font, which means each stroke has the outer edges and then the center, and that gave the best results when engraving. To place these tick marks, I calculated the spacing in millimeters that I needed for each of the different map scales. For example, this one is at 1 to 10,000 scale, and so each of these tick marks represents 10 meters, which works out to be 1 millimeter on the card at a 1 to 10,000 scale. When I drew the tick mark lines, I was careful to make each vector start on the part and end off the part because that's the direction the tool path is going to travel. Here's the quick engrave tool path I used for making this logo. And I used the hatch option with a hatch angle of 90 degrees so that I would get vertical lines filling in the logo. And it draws these vertical lines, and then it draws the outline as well. And that gave a good result with a half millimeter step over. The engraving toolpath for everything else uses the outline option. And the outline option will simply draw one stroke for each of the tick marks. And then if I zoom in, you can see that it's drawing three strokes for each of the lines of the text. Here's the vacuum fixture that I made to hold the cards like this. I made it from MDF, which is, it's cheap, but it's porous. And so to use it for a vacuum fixture, I sprayed it with polyurethane to seal the pores, and that worked pretty well. I've got an air outlet on the side with a quick release. It's a bicycle style fitting, and this goes to my little vacuum pump. And then there's a hole that comes in and comes out here, and I sealed that with polyurethane as well. I've got a gasket around the outside. I milled a channel with the CNC for this gasket. And originally I was going to use the CNC to drill a hole at the top of the card, but I changed my mind, so I don't really need this jog anymore, but it doesn't hurt anything. The gasket material, you can buy this on Amazon. I'll put a link on my webpage at brainwright.com and a link to that in the video description. But I've got a couple different sizes. So this material is right around 3 millimeters in diameter, and that size works pretty well for smaller parts. To fit this gasket material in and have it stay, I had to mill this groove just a little bit narrower and so that it would kind of wedge in there. And then I also milled it a little shallower so that it sticks up above the surface a little bit. I'll put the exact dimensions out on the website page. When I made this fixture, I carefully aligned the left edge of this MDF with the axis of the CNC, and then when I put it back on the CNC to machine cards, I again aligned this left edge. Then to get it centered, I took a card blank and I carefully scratched a little cross in the very center using a pair of calipers, and then I moved the gantry of the CNC to that spot to zero out X and Y. I zero out the Z-axis when the bit just touches the card. So if I machine, for example, half a millimeter below the surface, that'll compress the spring-loaded bit by half a millimeter. So when I'm using this, I put the card in, and then I connect my vacuum hose like that. I don't have a valve, I just connect it. The seal is not perfect, and I do get some air leakage through the MDF, even though it's sealed. So my vacuum pump is pulling about 15 inches of mercury vacuum. That's roughly 7.5 pounds per square inch. And the area around the gasket is about 5 square inches. So roughly speaking, I got about 37 pounds of clamping force here, and that's more than enough. I run my CNC machine using the modular CNC controller that I built, and I've got a whole video on building that you can check out if you want. Once I have the card loaded on the vacuum fixture and the G-code loaded in the CNC controller, then I just hit run and away it goes. It takes about 15 minutes to do the entire card, and I could probably speed that up a bit, but honestly I'm just not in a big hurry, and 15 minutes is fine, so I just start it running and set a timer, and then come back when it's done, and I've got a finished card. I put a bunch of extra info out on a webpage on my website at brainwright.com, and there's a link in the video description that'll have links to some of the stuff that I used to make the fixture and for the engraving and for the card blanks, and also information about things like feeds and speeds in case you want to do this yourself. Well, I hope you found this entertaining and maybe useful, and if you have your own CNC, maybe you'll try making something similar. Thanks for watching.